Hello, Cloud Gurus. I'm Nigel Poulton, the author of the Kubernetes book and the KCNA book, all about how to smash the KCNA exam. Anyway, this is Kubernetes This Month, the show that keeps you up to date with all the news and announcements from the Kubernetes world. In this episode, we'll look at the latest trends from the CNCF Annual Survey of 2021, some cool stuff happening with Chaos Mesh, more money for finding Kubernetes vulnerabilities, another Docker birthday, and way more. Plus, something really cool right at the end. And I mean, really cool. Now, while you're here, be sure to subscribe because you know you want to be up to date with all the cool stuff happening with cloud and Kubernetes. Right, so hot off the press is the CNCF's annual report of 2021. And they're leading with the notion that Kubernetes has well and truly crossed the adoption chasm and it is properly mainstream. So, the headline stat is that according to the respondents, 96% of organizations are either evaluating or using Kubernetes. 96%! Now, while that blows my mind, it does kind of reflect the conversations that I'm having. I mean, I rarely speak with anyone these days that isn't doing something with Kubernetes. But you know what? Even the more mainstream consumer tech podcasts and stuff that I listen to, they're starting to drop the word Kubernetes into conversations. So even to me, it feels like it's breaking into the everyday vocabulary of regular tech people, like not just your geeky back-end developers. Anyway, another stat that I'm not surprised with is 79% of respondents are using managed Kubernetes, with Amazon EKS leading the pack there. Again, it's no surprise, just about everyone I speak to these days is consuming hosted Kubernetes. It's just so easy. Now, sticking with hosted stuff, 39% of respondents are using serverless. Okay, but of those 39%, 75% are using hosted serverless, and then 75% of those are using AWS Lambda. So 75% of the 75% of the 39%, head exploding, they're using Lambda. Either way, hosted Kubernetes is huge, serverless is being really well used, and the majority of serverless users are also using fully managed or hosted platforms, in particular, AWS Lambda. Now, all of this consumption via hosted or managed services is seen as Kubernetes going under the hood. So becoming less and less visible, yeah? More and more just part of the infrastructure that happens to be there. Kind of like, oh yeah, Kubernetes, it's in there somewhere, but you know what? We don't really get our hands dirty with that. A little bit like Linux, actually. So phones, tablets, TVs, doorbells, you name it, they all run Linux. But the users don't necessarily know. They interact with higher level abstractions. Well, Kubernetes is heading in a similar direction, which I think is a really good thing. But look, there's plenty more in the report and it's free to download. I've put a link in the description. Huge congratulations to the Chaos Mesh team and community as the project moves out of the CNCF sandbox and into the incubating stage. And that's no mean feat, a proper sign that the project is maturing. So a key concept of cloud native design is expecting things to fail. Like no matter how well you build stuff, things will always fail. So a well-designed environment handles failures really well, which sounds great on paper, but how do you actually do that? Well, I mean, loosely coupling things and distributing for high availability, that's table stakes. But knowing what kind of things can break and actually go wrong, that can be hard. And that's where Chaos Mesh comes into play. Basically, it injects all kinds of failures and other chaos into your Kubernetes dev and test environments, and you can see how well they hold up, or maybe how well they don't hold up. Maybe they crash and burn. So, for example, Chaos Mesh can throw in node failures, network, DNS, HTTP, and loads more chaos and failures, and it's got a decent dashboard for managing and monitoring your chaos experiments. The project's got over 50 users, it's got over 125 contributors from more than 60 organizations, and it's had over 30 releases. Now, it was originally accepted as a CNCF sandbox project in the summer of 2020, but just now, in February 2022, it's progressed to incubating. So, if you haven't checked it out yet, you should. It's actually fun, but It's really important if you're serious about Kubernetes in production. Keen to start your cloud journey? We've just launched a new limited time offer for our Personal Plus annual plan, saving you 36%. The Personal Plan gives you access to great course features like hands-on labs and practice exams, making it easier to kickstart your cloud career. If you're interested, scan the QR code on the screen or click the link in the description. Okay, so time for my other top picks from February. Docker is having another birthday. And this year, it's turning 9 years old, which is hard to believe, really. Has it been that long since Solomon Hikes did his infamous misspelled Hello World container at PyCon? Anyway, look, they're holding an online annual community meetup with a bunch of great cool stuff. They've got news, panels, specialist tracks, and loads more, and it's free. On Valentine's Day, the Google security blog announced it was expanding its current Kubernetes bug bounty program until at least the end of the year 2022. Basically, they're super keen to catch vulnerabilities, and they're offering from $20,000 to over $90,000 US, that is, for anyone who can compromise their Kubernetes CTF sandbox. Apparently, they paid over $175,000 US in the last 3 months alone, and they're keeping the program and its increased payouts live until at least the end of 2022. The second annual IstioCon will be on the 25th to the 29th of April, and it'll be 100% virtual. And then last, but absolutely not least, and this is the cool thing that I mentioned at the top of the show, so I hope you're not disappointed, but if you don't already know, Honeypot have released a really well-made Kubernetes documentary. Yeah, absolutely. Now, it's in two parts, and it tracks the rise of Kubernetes and cloud native. I've seen most of it, and in fact, I might watch the rest of it tonight, actually. But seriously, it really is well made, and it is a proper good watch if you're into this stuff. So, the link's below, and I think you'll love it. I reckon it should be on, like, Netflix or Amazon Prime or something. And that's it for this month. If you like this episode, you can check out more of our original series with an ACG free plan. You'll also get access to our learning paths and our new courses every month, like our newly added on-theme free course this month, Docker Deep Dive. And the best thing is, you don't even need a credit card to sign up. Check out the links below. And on that note, stay safe, and I'll see you again next month, same cube time, same cube place.